I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
He told me he was supposed to fight recently.
I thought he was fighting like last week or 2 weeks
ago. They got canceled.
Huh?
Yeah. But he still wants to fight. But that's cool. It's very nice when you can keep it professional and still be friends and homies after the fight or not.
That's the way boxing is. Sometimes you're, you know, friends growing up, amateurs, whatever, then you fight each other in pros. Or you are working together and then you end up fighting.
Like
I
said,
I fought Lopez, and I saw him a couple weeks ago in Florida, and we're hanging out. Yeah,
and you had beef with Gamboa.
It was cool. Gamboa was right there, too, chilling, you know.
Well, this is what I said. Mares and Santa Cruz are the only two guys who didn't say one negative thing ever and sold 12,000.
It's because they respect Chinese. That's the way it is. Unless someone started something one
day.
Yeah,
or Andrew, yeah. Or the teams, yeah. How did you like Charlo's ring entrance?
The lion?
Yep.
What does he say, lion's den or lion's
only? Lion's
only. Lion's only? He's bad. I think if he would have focused more on landing combinations, he would have stopped Trout. But Trout did well, hanging on.
Trout's a tricky guy.
He's got experience.
Trout's experience, tricky, yeah. But he was never a bad fighter.
No.
So he still has it. You could say he's old or already finished, but he still has experience. He still has good skills, and boxing's good. You know, he's tricky. So he's not gonna be easy against nobody. He's always gonna get some, unless he, you know, 5 years later when he's fucking 40, then you might say it's too much already. But right now he could still give anybody problems at 154.
A lot of people thought he'd be blown out in 3 rounds, 4 rounds, and he went all 12.
Yep.
But it must feel good that you have an official fight and everybody knows and you don't have to say we have a date, we have a location.
It's good because now we can focus directly on the opponent. We can start working on the game plans, sparring partners, you know, for a specific date and for a specific opponent.
Have you started watching his fights yet? Or? That's Robert and Big G.
That's Robert Big G.
Did you talk to him at all? His last fight was when you're on the card, right? No? Fortuna?
She fought before.
Okay, cool.
So I like it a month before.
Oh, okay. For some reason I thought it was the same card. Yeah, you're right. Why blue?
I don't know, Mikey just picked blue.
Blue outfit today?
No?
Blue outfit?
No. Where are the colors? I bought you.
Hey, it's the same colors like Loma.
What?
Blue and yellow.
Yeah, blue and yellow. We're Ukrainian.
We
want to be exactly like you. Where's the lasers?
Huh?
Oh, yeah. We have cards. I'm going to be throwing cards at Mikey. We have blocks. We're going to be putting blocks together. We have a bunch of new shit we're going to start making now.
Now, the little cards, like
games, we don't do that. We play Conquian.
What's
That's how we get ready for fighting.
What's the thing?
Play Conquian.
Was that it?
What?
This thing with the stick and the ball?
No, Conquian is a card game.
Oh. Did you tell Mikey about Michael Pena?
Yeah, I told him.
Did a lot of fans go crazy this weekend at Staples Center when they saw you?
Yeah.
A lot of autographs, pictures?
I saw a lot of people taking pictures of my car, too. They tagged me on the
Instagram.
Who you take? Oh, Brian. I told him it was Brian. And so people tagged me.
Yeah, Mikey?
Yeah. So they saw, they know the videos they see on Instagram.
Of course.
They see the car. So they saw it, so they would go and take a photo.
That's cool.
That's pretty cool. And then as I was leaving, some people saw me there and they came, you know, asking for a picture in front of the car.
Paso al lado de
I thought you were in Vegas this weekend. No, because Joe Sharp put up a post of Noel Torres and you.
No, he came down.
Oh, okay. So I was like, man, I'm in Vegas. They should have told me. Yeah. Rapper Noel Torres has blown up. He's become very famous now.
Yes.
He has like 700,000 followers.
He's always had good, good songs. He's come out with good songs and everything.
But he's popular. But when you sparred Salido, you got down.
I hired him to be my sparring partner, Elie. What do you expect? Right? The fuck? It's like, we hired, you know, come on.
What if he wanted to prove, you know, sometimes
sparring? Well, no, they do, of course they do, but he couldn't, not with me.
Did he look the same way after you sparred him?
Huh?
Did he look just like that?
I sparred Salido.
Did he look like that after sparring? Big G. When Robert sparred Salido.
Cuando yo sparré con Salido, cuando lo trajimos a sparring allá al campamento, a Salido. ¿Sí se acuerda usted? ¿Sí se acuerda?
Okay. ¿Cómo estaban los sparring? ¿Te acuerdas si eran sparring duro o estaban?
Sí, era bueno. He was a good sparring. He was young, tough.
Yeah, I know, I'm sure.
No estaba.
He was a gangster.
Sí, pues, yo sé.
So how many rounds today?
Just gonna do 8, 4 and 4.
And who's the second one?
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.